How's it going, everybody? It's Stas here, and in this video, we're going to be talking about the stock market, breaking down what happened today in the S&P, the Dow, and the NASDAQ, and I also want to share with you guys what stocks and ETFs that I'm watching and looking to trade as we're heading into the month of May in 2020, and I also want to break down a couple of earnings reports, such as Amazon, McDonald's. We'll take a look at what Apple reported, as well as Visa, to see kind of how are their stocks reacting and thus how are their stocks affecting the markets here after hours. And if you guys enjoyed the video, all I ask from you as always is to hit that like button for me and consider subscribing to the channel if you want to see further content like this. And for all of you that have been requesting an options video, I released an options video earlier today on the Webull platform. That's linked down below in the description box if you do want to check it out after this video, as well as the Discord chat and Facebook group, which are 100% free of charge to join. So let's just get right into it, guys, and go over kind of what went down today and what the market was anticipating. And obviously what the market was anticipating, let's just say that right away, it was Apple and Amazon's earnings. That's what the market has been anticipating. We got Google the other day. We got Facebook. We got Microsoft, a bunch of other big companies. But the two top dogs, Apple and Amazon, arguably, right? Some people would say Microsoft. Some people would say Google. But a lot of people would say Apple and Amazon are the two top dogs. They reported today, and we can clearly see by the futures, and we'll get into this in a little bit. The futures are down, guys, and that's kind of scary. It's not that scary, but the weighting that these companies have, right, the big guys, you know, Apple, Amazon, Facebook, you know, Microsoft, the weighting that these companies have on the overall markets is remarkable, and you guys have to understand that. So the S&P today ended up going down 27 points, down about almost 1%, down 0.92% to be exact. And based on this chart, it seems like the bulls are still in charge, right? You know, we arguably got a bit overheated yesterday. We got to about 2950. You know, we were pushing that 3000 territory like I was talking about in yesterday's video. So from a technical perspective, from a standpoint, looking at these technicals here, it makes sense that the S&P pulled down a bit because now we're getting closer to the old resistance. You know, we're going to potentially test that as a new support right around 2880 to about 2900, as well as that 50 SMA on the hourly chart. So for me, that is extremely healthy here in the S&P 500. And pulling back here a bit to the 4-hour chart, we also talked about how yesterday we broke out of the major moving average here, being the 180 SMA. That was extremely bullish. And the fact that we're still maintaining that, we're still above it as of right now, that is also good, right? That's also a good sign for the bulls. So one thing that's kind of alarming here, it's not too crazy, but still it's worth looking at, are these futures. The futures right now, they're down about 1.15%, but it doesn't really alarm me too much, like I said, because the uptrend is still intact, and it seems like we are holding that general 2860 to 2880 area of support that was an old resistance. So as long as the S&P is able to hold this level, the futures are able to hold this general 2850 to 2900 area as a support, that is good for the bulls here. And tomorrow is going to be a huge day, guys, because it's a Friday, right? A lot of the times the markets, you know, rally on Friday, or it's a huge red day on Friday. So we're going to see what ends up happening and how Apple and Amazon end up affecting the market throughout the day tomorrow. And I'm really interested in seeing what that ends up, looking like. And when it comes to the Dow Jones, down 1.17%, down about $290 on the day. And unlike the S&P on the 4-hour chart, which broke out of the major moving average yesterday, the Dow Jones Jones is still under it. You guys can see it here on the 4-hour. We're struggling, but a good thing is we did end up closing above 24,200 as a support. As you guys can see, we held at 24,345 at the close, and that's a good sign because we're holding an old resistance as a new support. So it seems like the bulls are in charge here on the NASDAQ as well, just briefly looking at the technicals, right? And when it comes to, the Dow, did I say the NASDAQ? I meant the Dow, right? We're looking at the Dow here, and the NASDAQ is it's doing very poorly. Actually, no, before the market closed, it was doing well. Actually, it closed 0.2% in the green, so it did very well compared to the other markets. But where it's doing poorly is in the futures market. You guys can see, the NASDAQ futures right now, they're down about 1.7%, as we'll see in a couple of minutes here, because Apple and Amazon are both down from, my last checking of the stocks. They're both down significantly after hours. So overall, the NASDAQ closed above 9,000, which is a good sign for the bulls, but it didn't hold. It didn't hold, guys, because, again, we're down about 150 in the futures market. So if we do end up going down 150 points tomorrow, we're going to be right around 88.50, right around here. That's if these futures hold. And we've seen it before. The futures completely wipe out the losses. They turn green. So who knows? Anything could happen. But either way, for the NASDAQ to be bullish in my eyes, we need to hold 8,900 to about 9,000, which at the end of the day, we're right around there at this point in time. And of course, we'll see how Apple and Amazon end up affecting the markets tomorrow and the NASDAQ in particular, since the NASDAQ is a tech heavy index. So that's kind of the technical breakdown for today's video. Not much has changed. Just a bit of a pullback here, and the futures markets are bleeding a bit deeper, which could cause problems tomorrow, but only time will tell. And I'd love to know what your thoughts are down below in the comments. And some other interesting data we got today, almost forgot to mention it, were the jobless claims. Jobless claims, the consensus, the estimate before this week's numbers came out was about 3.5 million jobless claims. And we all know it peaked at about, 6.6 million 2 to 3 weeks ago. That was the peak, and ever since then, it's been declining week after week. It went like 6.6 million, 5.5 million. Last week, we had about, 4.4 million, and this week, again, 3.5 million consensus, it ended up coming in at 3.839 million. So the estimate was, they lowballed it a bit. The actual was a lot, not a lot more, but a decent chunk higher than the estimate. And get this, guys, another piece of interesting news about the market. Guess what? The S&P 500 had its best monthly gain since 1987. The blue chip index was up 12.68% for April, and the Dow rose 11% for April, while the NASDAQ rose about 15.45%. So the markets this week, guys, and not even this week, the month of April, they were on fire. Some yearly gains of 7%, 8%, those used to be solid. Obviously, they're still good from historical measures, but now we're getting 12% in a month. So you can understand and put it into perspective how crazy those types of returns are. So let me know down below in the comments, again, what are your thoughts on the market? What are your thoughts on the month of April that we saw in the stock market? I would love to know, right? This market flying up, while the fundamentals aren't that great, arguably horrible, right? And I'd love to know, again, your thoughts on that. And typically at this point, we'd be doing a trading update, right? But for me, guys, I actually didn't trade today. I've mentioned in previous videos how I've been kind of slowly Not slowly, but cautiously approaching this week as we have the big players. The big players reporting earnings. We had Apple today. Again, we had Amazon. We had Facebook this week. We had Google, McDonald's, Starbucks, Microsoft. The list goes on. So I kind of wanted to wait until these companies reported, see what the markets do, what direction do the markets pick before kind of making a decision in certain trades. So I didn't do anything, but tomorrow is a completely new day. And now that we kind of see the market dipping down, this could open up either a dip buy opportunity in the short term here if the markets do end up rebounding. Or let's say if the S&P does end up somehow collapsing below 2850, this could open up a potential maybe short opportunity over the next couple of trading days, either by playing some, you know, put options via SPY, which is an ETF that tracks the S&P. And speaking of options, guys, I actually, again, uploaded a video earlier that you guys should definitely check out, which is linked down below in the description box. And another thing that you could do is SPXS. This goes up whenever the S&P is going down at a 3x rate. And mind you, this is a leveraged ETF. I do not recommend these for beginners. If you're more intermediate to advanced, feel free to do research on this and trade something like a leveraged ETF. And another thing that I love mentioning, and I try to mention whenever I talk about leverage ETFs, is it's important not to bag hold these and not to swing trade them. They are not meant to be swing traded. They're simply day trading tools that you can use to hop in and out and really just maximize your gain when it comes to specific indexes. Because at the end of the day, that's what a lot of these leveraged ETFs and ETNs do. They track individual, you know, indexes, different futures, different commodities, and it's leveraged returns. So there's a lot of potential, but there's a lot of risk as well. So approach these with caution. So let's just get into kind of what these big name companies ended up reporting today. Let's start off with McDonald's, because they actually reported in the morning. So we'll take a look at what they ended up doing and how their stock ended up reacting. So on this 20-day chart, we can see McDonald's has been on a clear uptrend. We hit $155, and if I zoom out a bit to the 30-day chart, you'll be able to see it even better. We were actually all the way down to $124, guys, believe it or not. Comment down below if you have any shares or if you bought McDonald's in this area. You're going to be up a lot right now, right? You've probably already cashed out if you were swing trading. I for sure would have already. But either way, you know, $124, we've been on an uptrend all the way up to 190. And with today's earnings report, it seems like we went from about 188 yesterday down to about 182. And heading into the close of the market, it seems like the McDonald's stock here, MCD, is holding the uptrend. So that is pretty solid, but we can also conclude that there's a strong resistance at about $190. So that is really tough there for McDonald's. And in general, they reported earnings of Q1 EPS $1.47 versus the $1.72 expected. So not too good in terms of EPS, and it's expected, guys, with what's going on right now, obviously, right? And revenue came in at $4.71 billion versus $5.02 billion estimated, so they missed there on revenue. And same store sales, which again is a metric that I was looking at, down about 3.4%, which is also not too great of a number there. So when it comes to McDonald's, as expected, guys, with a lot of these restaurant stocks, obviously since they're not getting as much business, they didn't do well. Earnings weren't that great, and the stock ended up going down about $6 to $8 per share from its close yesterday to the bottom here in terms of what it did in these past 24 hours. And sure, it could go even lower from here. And in my opinion, obviously, it depends on the market. If the market takes a massive dump, odds are McDonald's is going to follow. So just keep an eye on this one. The next one I want to get into is Apple, guys. And we have some interesting information here that I have on my notes regarding Apple. So they obviously reported, and just like a lot of these big names, guys, Apple is very volatile when earnings are announced. The stock went from 290 to 294 to 300. Now it's back down to 285. It's chilling at about 286 right now. So this is a very volatile stock. Maybe not as volatile as Tesla, maybe some of these other ones like Virgin Galactic. It's probably not on that level, but still, it's a pretty volatile stock. And when it comes to their earnings, actually, I don't even think I wrote it down on my notes here. That is my mistake there, but we could probably see it. No. I think I did wrote it. They reported, you guys can see, well, we could start with iPhone sales. iPhone sales came in at $28.96 billion. Mac sales came in at $5.35 billion. iPad sales came in at $4.36 billion. Wearables, home, and accessories came in at $6.28 billion. And oh, here it is, guys. EPS of 255. Actually, I did have that here in my notes. EPS came in at 255 versus the 224 expected, and they reported revenue of 58.3 billion, which when you compare that to a year ago, here in my notes, I've written, it says up 1% from a year ago with profits of 255 a share, which I just said, those are up 4%. So the growth is just, it's obviously slowing down due to what's going on right now with the CV. And the Wall Street forecast had called for 54.5 billion and revenue and profits of 2.26 billion a share. And back in February, Apple actually withdrew its original guidance for the March quarter, which had called for, get this, guys, 63 billion to 67 billion of revenue. So they went from originally expecting about 63 to 67 billion to reporting about 58 billion. So you can see how those numbers were affected there. And get this too, guys. Apple also announced a dividend increase of about 6% to 82 cents a share, and it's also going to do another $50 billion share buyback program. And the company also boosted its repurchase authorization by $75 billion a year ago and $100 billion the year before that while upping its dividends. So many people look at the share buybacks as a awful way to use capital. And in this situation, you're noticing a lot of these companies that bought back their shares, like Boeing, they bought back their shares, inflated the stock price up to 400. You know, a lot of these airlines buying back their shares. These companies are the ones that are in need of bailout. Obviously, Apple is not in need of a bailout, but still, them buying back shares arguably is a problem because instead of, yeah, sure, for Apple, they have a lot of cash, but for these companies like Delta, Boeing, that don't have a lot of cash and need the bailout, instead of buying these shares back, they could have just kept that cash in cash, and when tough times hit, they'd be able to weather the storm. But that's obviously not happening now. They're in need of a bailout, those companies and many more companies. And, you know, it seems like the bailouts are still going to continue for certain companies. Obviously, like I just said, Apple, $50 billion, buyback program, it's saying here. And the next company I want to go over is Amazon. They also reported numbers today, obviously. Their stock was arguably inflated as well, up to $2,500 nearly per share. And I've told you guys, you know, if earnings come out a bit, you know, off, whatever, this stock is almost priced to perfection, it's going to fall down like a brick. Well, it kind of did that. It went from $24.75 all the way down to about $23.28. It was down about 6, 7% after hours at one point. And this is because of EPS, $5.01. That completely missed the estimate of $6.25. Revenue came in at $75.5 billion versus $73.6 billion. So EPS missed, and that is really because of the CV at the end of the day. You know, a lot of their expenses have been increasing due to kind of shipping costs and all that stuff. But either way, revenue ended up going up. And comparing year-over-year numbers here, net sales of $75.5 billion was up 26% year over year, which is pretty solid, right? But net income actually fell 30% from $3.6 billion or $7.09 per share to $2.5 billion or $5.01 per share in the quarter of 2019. So that's interesting, guys. You know, net sales up over year, net income down. And obviously, you know, Jeff Bezos said that he predicts shrinking profits on pandemic expenses. That makes sense. It's definitely, you know, more expensive, I'd say, at this point to, you know, ship all of these orders from my understanding. And another interesting thing about Amazon is it's going to spend its entire quarter two operating profit on the CV response, and that is about $4 billion. So a lot of information there to digest, and that's a good thing that they're doing, I'd say, about $4 billion to the, you know, CV response. But at the end of the day, guys, you know, Amazon's a trillion-dollar company, so $4 billion, not saying that it's not good that they're doing that. It's great that they're doing that, but $4 billion is still a droplet in the bucket for them. And when it comes to Visa, another big company here, they reported earnings after hours here. They ended up doing EPS of $1.39 versus $1.35 estimated, with revenue of $5.9 billion versus the $5.75 billion. And this is another interesting one. We ended up getting rejected at about 185, strong level of resistance there from a couple of months ago. And on this 30-day chart, you guys can see we're pulling back to an interesting old level of resistance at about 175, and we're holding that. So this level, 175, 50 SMA on this 30-day chart, on the hourly chart, right around the 50 SMA as well. This could be an awesome entry for Visa here in the short term, you know, on a swing trade. If the markets do end up, you know, swinging back up, I really think that this could be an awesome opportunity. So another stock that did well today was Netflix. Out of a bunch, you know, a bunch of the stocks were red today, believe it or not, guys. Obviously, as the markets were red, but Netflix, out of my watch list at least, was one of the stocks that was green, up about 2% today, up $8 per share. And this one is actually down after hours as well. And to be honest, guys, I'm not looking at Netflix unless we break out of 430, maybe back out of 425. Just generally, I want to see some sort of direction to the upside before getting into Netflix. And did you guys see CCL today? And yesterday it was at $18.50 after hours. Now we're seeing a sizable pull down back to about, you know, 15 to about, you know, 15.50. This could be an interesting spot in tomorrow's session. SPCE also is slowly starting to break some pretty critical levels. We broke 1780 as a support. We didn't end up holding that. Now we're about to test about 1730 to about 1720. So keep an eye on that level, and anything above 1780 for SPCE into the 18s. I think that's a buy area, you know, anywhere from 18 up to 20 bucks. I think that's a sizable, or that's a move that could easily happen here on SPCE. So those are kind of the stocks that I wanted to go over in today's video and kind of some thoughts here about the market. We're seeing gold back under $1,700. GDX, Gold Miners ETF, is down a pretty decent chunk today, down about 5.2%, although the uptrend is still intact. So GDX, this could be an opportunity tomorrow if we're able to hold 32 bucks, in my personal opinion. And those options that I'm holding in the Webull account and in some other accounts as well for GDX, they're actually down. It's not all sunshine and rainbows, guys. I was up about 90%, 100% last week, which goes to show why it's important to lock in profits. It's super important to lock in profits, guys. Last week, I locked a bit of profits on those options when I was up 90%, whatever it was. And now that I'm up like 20 or 30%, 35% on the options, you know, I'm not kicking myself because I locked in a little bit, you know, last week. And although I do have time on my side here, it's still a comfortable feeling that, you know, hey, I locked in some profits, and I'm going to let the other contracts ride out. And again, if you want to check out that Webull options video, that is linked down below in the description box. So I'll wrap up the video here, guys. If you enjoyed it, hit that like button for me. Consider subscribing to the channel if you haven't, and let me know down below in the comments, what are your thoughts on the markets, the stock market in general, individual stocks? I would love to know. And also, you can claim two free stocks valued up to $1,400 using my affiliate link down below in the description box. All you have to do is put in $100 into the account and you get those two free stocks, and it supports the channel and all the free content that I'm putting up here on YouTube. And I would really appreciate you guys for doing that. And in general, guys, I appreciate you guys so much for just watching the content and supporting the channel. It means the world to me. So I'll catch you all in the next video. Thanks again for watching. As always, guys, peace out.